Our first stop aboard the Holland America's MS Rotterdam was at the capital city of Alaska, Juneau. It's nestled on a small area just below the rocky crags of a mountain range and stretches about a mile and a half long. When you're in Alaska, you're never far from nature. As we prepare to disembark, we found out that we literally got the red carpet treatment. Sue was ready to go, and she had some plans of what we were going to do that day.
I'm going whale hunting. With my camera.
One of the first things you'll see when you depart from the MS Rotterdam in Juneau is a mural that depicts the Native American Tlingit creation story of the raven and the first man, how the raven gave light to the world.
One of the more famous places on your visit to Juneau is the Red Dog Saloon. And yes, it's everything that you've ever heard it could be. And they have a special outlook on customer service. On our way to find the whales, we found a pair of mating bald eagles. And a great sunny day was just fine for relaxing.
Type of battery do you use?
I got some great photos, and Kevin shot some great video of our first whales that we've seen. We've seen a couple of them, double ones. We've seen them blowing. We've seen their tails. Woohoo!
After a morning of whale watching, we were off for a short walk through a virgin forest. As you can see, the scenery is incredible. Glacier-fed streams. Trees covered with moss and lichen. Rock formations formed by the receding glaciers. The peacefulness of this forest was beyond description. And our guide also shared some insight about the trees and plants within the forest.
Okay, what we have is the stiff club moss down here. And this is the plant that dominated North America 400 million years ago. And it dominated because it didn't have competition. 400 million years ago, we didn't have strawberries and spruce trees. We had nothing with seeds. The world was covered with mosses and lichen. And this was the king of mosses. When we had the temperature change, it crashed, right? The coal fields are already starting to form, and now it survives, but it survives in this small form. It doesn't make it less interesting, though, because this plant has a role in early 20th century birth control, which I'll answer on an individual basis. It is also for the photo historians. You've all seen pictures of the photographers back in the 1880s taking the pictures with their view cameras, and they take the lens cap off and they'd held up a trough of explosive, right? And they set it off and there's a big flash of light. That powder in the troughs was the spore of the stiff club moss. That's what made the first flash photography, this plant. It is also, on a domestic level, it is the talcum powder of the old Tlingit Indians. This is what you put on your baby's bottom to keep from getting diapers rash. They didn't have Johnson & Johnson talcum powder. You harvested the spore of the stiff club moss.
And how high did it grow?
180 feet or 60 meters. Now we're lucky to get one 6 or 7 inches. Once you see it, you'll spot it on the floor of the forest all over. But until someone points it out to you, it doesn't really jump out at you. It doesn't capture light in any particular fine way, but it does give you these nice little delicate vertical greens.
The Mendenhall Glacier is in the Tongass National Forest, just 13 miles from downtown Juneau.
The blue tint to Alaska's glaciers is due to the fact that its snow crystals compressed over hundreds and thousands of years. No matter how cold you would try to freeze regular ice, you'll never get that bluish color because the snow crystals have a different crystalline structure than regular ice.
The bluish-white glacier is 12 miles long, 1.5 miles wide, and 100 feet tall. The ice can be 400 to 800 feet deep. It currently recedes about 100 to 150 feet a year, and it's fed from the Juneau ice field. There are an estimated 100,000 glaciers in Alaska.